Acid-base reactions involve the donation of a proton from acid to base. In oxidation-reduction reactions, electrons are transferred rather than protons. The species that donates the electron is the reducing agent, and the species that accepts the electrons is the oxidizing agent. Just as an acid cannot react without a base, a reducing agent cannot react without an oxidizing agent. However, unlike acids and bases, where we consider proton transfers one at a time, the electron transfer may involve the simultaneous transfer of multiple electrons. As a result, we often simplify an oxidation-reduction reaction by splitting it into two half-reactions, an oxidation and a reduction. We characterize an oxidation as a loss of electrons, so the reducing agent is the reactant in the oxidation. Reduction is the gain of electrons, so the oxidizing agent is the reactant in the reduction. Keep in mind that neither half-reaction can occur on its own. One needs the other, and for it to make sense, the number of electrons must be the same in each if we wish to have a proper balanced reaction. The concept of oxidation and reduction is so useful that we want to use it in situations where electrons are not fully transferred from one atom to another. An example of this would be covalent molecules, where electrons are shared, but they're not perfectly shared. With oxidation numbers, we adopt a model where the most electronegative atom within the bond takes all of the electrons found within that bond. Later on in the semester, we will see how we can determine oxidation states simply using Lewis dot structures. But for now, we will be given a set of rules, such as a pure element always has an oxidation state of 0, fluorine is always negative 1, calcium is always positive 2, and oxygen is usually negative 2, except in peroxide, where it's negative 1. The most important rule is the last one, and it states that the last remaining element in the compound after the orderly application of the rules must absolutely take the oxidation state required to give the chemical species the appropriate charge. Finally, remember that each atom of an element possesses the same oxidation state, so we must take into account the number of atoms of each element when calculating the oxidation state of the final element.